It's got everything vacationers could wish for. Unspoiled wilderness.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Fun places to see and some of the best fishing in the U.S.
Pretty awesome, yeah.
I don't know, there's something kind of magical about it. It's just a nice place to go.
And it's all perched at the very top of Minnesota. Tonight, come along on the road as we discover this great getaway destination called Rainy Lake.
The next buoy is going to be right here.
Can you imagine seeing this enormous lake and Minnesota's only national park any other way than by houseboat?
You never get tired of the scenery.
Get a close-up look at this floating lifestyle.
You know what the problem is? The fish are all on this side of the boat.
See why a fishing trip plus lunch, Rainy Lake style, are ingredients for a memorable day. And don't miss the hotel you can only reach by boat.
It got the nickname the Tilton Hilton at one point.
They serve drinks straight up and on a slant at the same time.
I'm Jason Davis. Come along as we explore beautiful Rainy Lake.
When we go on the road, there's a place I want to see. When we go on the road, why don't you come with me? Take a little ride. Get a little windshield time. When we go on the road.
This is a water park like no other. Hundreds of islands, miles of spectacular shoreline, pristine forests and wildlife to marvel at. And it's all here, right at the top of Minnesota.
We're venturing out onto Rainy Lake in a 48-foot houseboat. It's a wonderful way to set your own pace and to get to know this beautiful area. Rainy Lake, with its bays, inlets and islands, has more shoreline than Lake Superior.
It may be 300 miles from the Twin Cities, but it's well worth the drive. This is undoubtedly the jewel in the crown of Minnesota. The 218,000 acres of Rainy Lake is dotted with more than 16,000 islands. It's so big, it encompasses a large part of Minnesota's only national park. Some people say it's like the boundary waters with motorboats. As big as this lake is, it's easy to spot the giant white houseboats that lumber along exploring the spectacular scenery. Some are privately owned, but most are rented from a couple of major outlets less than 10 miles by road from International Falls. It's as easy as renting a car. We showed up at Northern Air Houseboats to sign up for a rig from the fleet owned by Dick Garvey and his family.
So I take full responsibility for everything?
Yes, sir. You break it, you buy it.
Dick explains how to read the simple charts that are supplied to every renter. He says you can't get lost.
The farthest east you can go is Kettle Falls to the dam and the hotel down there, and that's roughly 6 hours out by houseboat in good weather. And that's your boat right down there, houseboat 25.
It's an amazingly fast transition. It only takes about 30 minutes to turn a complete landlubber into the captain of a totally self-contained boat nearly 50 feet long. A short guided tour of number 25 includes a complete checklist of equipment and some important instructions.
We require houseboats to be parked by 6 o'clock every evening.
Oh, you do?
Yes, yeah, and that's just a safety purpose. Rainy's a beautiful, beautiful lake, but you have to have respect for it.
Dick Garvey's family have been living in the St. Croix Valley since the 1870s, but after retiring as an electrical wholesaler, he was entranced by this far northern part of Minnesota.
And we had a beautiful house in Scandia, but I didn't want to say when I'm 70 years old, you know, why am I looking at these same trees, you know, instead of trying something different. The front has your... Actually, it was the best move I ever made, Jason. You know,
why do you say that?
I'm doing something I really, really love, and if it ever becomes work, then I'll sell, you know? You never get tired of the scenery. That's one nice thing about Rainy Lake.
This houseboat has bunks for up to 8 people, a screened-in porch for barbecues, a small bathroom with an even smaller shower, and a kitchen complete with stove and good-sized refrigerator. The steering wheel and controls are in the main cabin and easy to learn. It is routine for experienced staff members like 20-year-old Joe Vita to show novices the ropes for the first few miles. But I was anxious to take command of my own ship.
Okay, yep. Would you like to give it a try, sir?
It may look difficult, but in fact, people from all walks of life come here to vacation on these houseboats on Rainy Lake. It wasn't long before we drifted up to a boat nosed into one of the many sandy beaches marked on the charts as being good waterside campsites.
Beautiful beach, peaceful, quiet.
Nancy and Bill Weber have been coming here for years from their home in Cedar Rapids, Iowa, to have some quality time with their grandchildren. The 34-inch northern just caught by Nancy will make a fine supper.
The money we save eating in restaurants we spend on the houseboat.
It's just much easier because we're in Cedar Rapids not to have to trail something this big.
You can base yourself where you want to be to go fishing every day.
But on a houseboat, you have to take care of yourself. Breakfast for photographer Phil Tesey and myself was bacon and eggs and toast. I cooked, Phil took the video. Oh no. Ow. We soon learned that not only do you have to bring all your food with you on a houseboat, but also paper towels and even simple things like condiments.
You want some pepper?
My pepper?
No, thanks.
Get some salt.
We got the salt.
A houseboat is not a hotel, and at least on this vessel, the chores have to be shared. Probably the best thing about houseboating is the freedom to travel anywhere on the vast lake without worrying about hotels and meals. Much of the shoreline is actually in Minnesota's only national park, and a popular destination for boaters and motorists is the spectacular Voyageurs National Park Visitors Center. Here you can learn that this historic waterway was a major route for the intrepid voyageurs who 200 years ago passed this way trading for furs, and you can even feel the furs. But people were here 10,000 years ago, and you can explore the whole history of this unique area. The National Park Service also organizes regular guided boat tours that take visitors to many of the most beautiful and historic places on the lake. We were surprised to learn that in 1893, a search for gold resulted in a very determined effort to strike it rich. On a small island, men with a gleam in their eye burrowed into the dense rock in search of the mother lode. They were disappointed, and the Rainy Lake gold rush was all over in less than 5 years.
Most of Rainy Lake and Voyageurs National Park is a vast, unspoiled wilderness. But at the far east end, 30 miles from civilization, there's a surprise. This hotel with a story to tell.
The Kettle Falls Hotel is perhaps the oddest inn in the country. The nearest road is more than 20 miles away.
Couples will come and stay here. It's a nice getaway, a unique feeling, because you can only get here by boat or by float plane.
Built about 100 years ago to accommodate workers from the logging and paper industry, Kettle Falls hasn't changed a lot. It's a great place to stop for a meal in a cozy atmosphere after being out on the lake all day. And after eating, you can explore the historic site. The old dam keeper's cabin still stands, and the local trading post is open for business during the summer. The Kettle Falls Hotel was acquired by the National Park Service in 1977, and they discovered that over the years the foundations had buckled and heaved.
It got the nickname the Tilton Hilton at one point, and so when the National Park Service rehabilitated the building, they felt that we should maintain that character of the building, and so they kept the slant in the floor as a feature that people come to look for.
That explains why the top of the pool table is about the only level surface in the saloon. The floor sags alarmingly, giving the whole room the feel of a funhouse. No one seems to mind the permanent tilt, or maybe after a few beers they don't even notice. This bizarre feature is one of the most popular things to see in the whole of Rainy Lake.
Might be a keeper.
You've probably guessed the most popular thing to do here.
What do you think of that?
Coming up, see a traditional shore lunch on Rainy Lake. We'll sample the local delicacy.
This is the appetizer,
right? That's the appetizer.
what's lurking in the waters of this majestic lake. See why it's something vacationers and residents can't do without. We're back on the road and on the water exploring beautiful Rainy Lake at the top of our state.
They claim it's the finest fishing lake in Minnesota. Rainy Lake is allegedly teeming with walleye, northern and bass. So we thought we'd come out and try and catch lunch.
The fishing is one of the major reasons Rod Hannon moved up here from the Twin Cities.
My only regret is missing some of my friends. Otherwise, moving up here, this is a great place to be.
Rod and his family own and operate one of the best-known destinations on Rainy Lake.
Once people spend time here, they'll be back.
The Thunderbird Lodge is a popular place to stay, eat, and use as a base for fishing trips. And it's where we hooked up with a man who knows this lake and its fish better than most, John Gushelank, better known around these parts as Gator, a name he picked up on his winter trips to Florida. Gator has been guiding on this lake for nearly 40 years, and no one knows it better. A high-speed trip out to the fishing spot includes a commentary about the local scenery and wildlife, like why the beaver have cut down these trees.
They don't eat pine, but the reason they cut them down is to cut down their teeth.
It's a spot only the experts like Gator can recognize. A remote reef where, most of the time, the fish you catch are too big.
Sometimes we come to these reefs and we fish for these fish, and we have to go somewhere else to try to find small ones.
Because you're not allowed to keep the big ones.
We can't keep them. There are spawners.
For the past 11 years, the fishing on Rainy Lake has been protected by rules that allow anglers to only keep fish under 17 inches and one trophy over 28 inches long. I was practicing catch and release, but only because the first few walleye were too small. But as the day warmed up, so did the fishing, and pretty soon I was boating fish just the right size for eating. The score was soon Jason 3, Gator 0.
You know what the problem is? That fish are all on this side of the boat.
Naturally, it wasn't long before the master made a fool of the novice, and Gator was hauling in much bigger fish, some too big to keep.
He said, "Thank you very much."
It turned out to be a beautiful day. The Grandmo family from Duluth were fishing nearby and agreed that Rainy Lake is a great place to be.
Well, there's something kind of magical about it. It's just a nice place to go.
The Grandmos have heavily populated one of the larger campsites on the lake. Four brothers and their families have staked a claim to one of the most beautiful places on earth. Debbie Grandmo was about the only one not fishing.
It's quiet and it's relaxing and just get away for a while.
And fresh food is only a cast away.
We're having a Friday night fish fry this time. So
that's why they're out there.
That's why they're out there.
It was time for us to eat, and Gator chose one of the most scenic places on the lake to cook as a traditional shore lunch. These buildings used to house a commercial fishing operation, but the business is now an historic site the Park Service hopes to develop as a tourist attraction. It's remarkably well preserved, right down to the sawdust still lying in the bottom of the old ice storage building. After cleaning half a dozen fish that only minutes before were swimming in the lake, Gator started cooking an unforgettable meal.
While I'm cooking a fish, you can make yourself a bacon and onion sandwich. Famous for Rainy Lake.
Now, there's a dish we've never heard of. Gator fried up a huge pile of bacon and cut up a big fresh onion. The result is a local delicacy.
This is a famous Rainy Lake bacon and onion sandwich, and you must squeeze lemon on the onion first to make it taste like apples. This is the appetizer,
right? That's the appetizer.
Nothing beats eating fresh fish on an island in Rainy Lake. A few feet away, blueberries ripen for dessert. It's the reason most people come here to the top of Minnesota, and it doesn't seem to matter what kind of fish you catch.
Can you tell the difference between walleye and northern if somebody gave you a mouthful of it?
Probably not.
No,
probably not.
Here's someone who knows every inch of the lake for a very good reason.
I love this job.
Coming up, meet the guy vacationers and residents love to see. plus our on-the-road tour of nearby International Falls, including the fastest paper-making machine in the world.
Rainy Lake is connected to nearby International Falls by the Rainy River. And while you're up here, this city is well worth a visit.
It was the river and the falls that attracted the early lumber mills and paper makers to this border city. Today, nearly 100 years later, the major employer is still Boise Paper Solutions, home of one of the world's fastest paper-making machines. And you even get to see it. We joined a small group of visitors on a quick tour of this huge plant with guide Stephanie Davis.
This machine runs close to 41 miles an hour, and that means we're making paper at double the speed of the other machine.
This paper-making plant runs 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. International Falls is a bright and prosperous town with lots of Main Street-style shopping and even a last chance to buy duty-free stuff before crossing the bridge into Canada. One of the city's greatest claims to fame is that it's the hometown of a man they say is the greatest football player of all time. The Bronco Nagurski Museum is a graphic tribute to this dynamo of a guy who more than 60 years ago dominated both professional football and professional wrestling. The museum adjoins the Coochaching County Historical Collection, which features the story of 10,000 years of native culture. A great place for visitors to get to know International Falls, the icebox of the nation.
Well, we're from Alabama, so we can't imagine the cold.
To reach us online, go to kstp.com. Select KSTP TV 5, then click on the road.
I'm the only one on the whole Great Lakes.
Climb aboard the most unusual vessel on Rainy Lake when we come back.
On any given summer's day, there's hundreds, perhaps even thousands of boats of all shapes and sizes on Rainy Lake. But there's only one U.S. Coast Guard officially designated merchant marine vessel, and that's the good ship Harbor Lights under the command of her captain, Carl Brown.
It is definitely a weird sight as it appears out of the lake to loom up along the shoreline of the cabins and resorts on Rainy Lake. But this is one strange ship that's always welcome.
I'm the smallest United States registered tank ship in the country.
Carl Brown is one of the best known characters on Rainy Lake. Fishing guide, nightclub owner, building contractor, and tank ship operator are just some of his many interests and occupations. His introduction to tank ship operation came after he started hauling a little propane gas to users around the lake on his old construction barge.
And I thought I better check with the Coast Guard, make sure I have the right fire extinguishers. Well, $100,000 later, I'm a United States tank ship.
And the only one in the...
I'm the only one on the whole Great Lakes.
Today, Carl Brown hauls a wide range of fuels to thousands of vacationers and year-round residents in both Canada and the United States.
We can have diesel, gasoline, jet fuel, 100 OLED for airplanes at times. This is a pretty versatile vessel.
Deckhand Mike Peterson drags a heavy high-pressure hose through mosquito-infested woods to holding tanks while Captain Carl Brown operates pumps on board the ship. It's a tough job, but one Carl says he will never give up. Never.
I love this job. I never intend on retiring. And I've made it my wish to my relatives that I wish my I want my ashes to ride on this vessel around the lake forever.
In the winter, this place is a paradise for snowmobilers and ice fishermen. But it's during the oh-so-short summer season this is truly a beautiful place to be. No wonder their slogan is, Rainy Lake replenishes what the rest of the world takes away. I'm Jason Davis. Drive carefully, and we'll see you next week.